I did want to mention what I'm putting on this. Yeah. Get there. Boiled linseed oil. That ought to go well next to the kerosene heater. Flammable. So, we'll kill that heater here in a few minutes. It'll warm up in here. Be good. That's what I used on, that's the oil I used on this as well. Works really well. Once it gets hardened, it's a pretty good preservative. So let's get started. Got that second tailgate oiled up, and it actually has quite a bit more patina on it. I'll heat it up here so we can see it. Has this nice warm spot here. Unfortunate thing is there's some green, kind of mint green paint right there, but all in all, looks pretty good. And then there's the back side. And then I decided to just go ahead and sandblast the frame. Fairly pitted. It actually looks worse in video through the phone than it does in real life. I did cover this when I blasted, so I gotta clean all that off. Got both of these little boogers freed up. Both working really smooth now. And pretty much this guy looked exactly like this frame looks before I oiled it. So I've oiled that down and a lot of that blue paint is showing through and still pretty good, so I think we're gonna roll with it. So I am not gonna paint the frame this time. And I am going to go for the keeping the vintage vibe. Crusty. It'll match the rest of my stuff. So it's all been sandblasted. And I did paint the wheel. And it turned out okay. I sandblasted it also. And then the body has all been oiled down. Kind of hard to see. Dark in here. Need a shot with some light. That's a little better. So, I'm gonna get this oiled down, hopefully tonight, and maybe start putting it back together. I should be able to get a wheel on it tomorrow. I did get new galvanized bolts for it too, so should be good to go. A little coffee, a little kerosene heat, and we're set. I did want to mention what I'm putting on this. Yeah, there. Boiled linseed oil. That ought to go well next to the kerosene heater. Flammable. So, we'll kill that heater here in a few minutes. It'll warm up in here. It'll be good. That's what I used on. That's the oil I used on this as well. Works really well. Once it gets hardened, it's a pretty good preservative. So let's get started. So here it is all oiled up. This is the back side. I flipped it over. But I just didn't want to lose that paint. I know. Probably should have painted it, but we'll see what happens. It may get to the point where I think it needs to be painted, and if that's the case, it's easy enough to take apart. It's 9 bolts, actually less than that. There's 2 in the front, or 2 in the back, 2 in the front, and I think 3 on the sides, 1, 2, 3. So, not that big a deal to take apart if I decide to do that. So I think my next step tonight, I'm going to leave that piece off because it weighs about 25-30 pounds. And if I'm going to be manipulating this by myself, I don't need the extra weight. So I'm going to flip the frame back over, and then try putting the box on it, see how that goes. Funny little thing, today in my sandblasting endeavor, I failed to remember to do these little guys. So, I will be doing those tomorrow, and oiling them as well before I stick them back on the corners inside. Just incredible where I found this thing and the shape that all this stuff is in. Alright, don't forget to do parts. Well, it took about an hour and a half later, but the frame is on. There are a couple bolts I need to go through and cut off. I just don't like this hanging. And somebody had put piping on there before and put little feet down on it. They must have used it for camping or something. I didn't put those back on. So I think I'm going to leave it here for tonight. I did put in a couple of little eye bolts using the holes that were already there, already drilled. Otherwise I have to put a dowel rod or something through them. So that is that. So give that a few days to soak, and then I'll probably wipe it down again just to make sure that everything's good. A few bolts to cut. Funny enough, I didn't realize it when I took it apart. I don't think these are factory. I don't think these are original. But again, I'm going to go ahead and put them in. These ones that come between the pillars. There's a pillar there and a pillar here. So factory has a bolt hole there, a bolt hole there. The holes are much drilled out much bigger. The one that is here, I think, was part of this little pipe setup somebody drilled through. I got all of them but one. And funny enough, there is no hole in the frame. Right there. Nada. So, for consistency's sake, I'm going to drill that out and put that one through as well, just to give it, so that gives us an extra one here, an extra one there, an extra one down low, and an extra one down low in the front. So, I think, go ahead and drill that one out. Don't see any reason not to. Aesthetically, it doesn't look as good, but I think I'll go ahead and do it just to, if for nothing else, to cover a couple of the holes that were already in the bed. Oh, putting in the carriage bolt back here. I had a casualty. So I'll have to loosen that guy back up. Oops, sorry about that. The camera wasn't looking at you. I'll loosen that back up and glue that back in there, unfortunately. That is that. So I think I'll, for this evening, set it down. Because the way our luck runs around here, it'd probably fall over if I don't. And we'll call it a night. One thing I failed to mention is I do use boiled linseed oil. These are kerosene rags in the trash. Boiled linseed oil rags are over here. Don't leave those in your house. It's just not a good idea. It's flammable. Gives how it actually gets rid of itself, for lack of a better phrase, is it evaporates out. That can cause a fire. So you want to get those out if you can. The best way to do it is to just stick them under a rock in the yard and let them just kind of air dry and get hard, and then throw them away. I am actually going to fold up this piece of cardboard, that rag, this piece of cardboard, and probably get the one that's under the trailer too, and get all of that out of here. I don't want that in my house. I've been in here all day, it's probably gonna be fine, but it's just one of those things that just take the extra. It's that whole safety third. In this case, let's just not do that. I just wanted to give you a heads up to not leave those in your house, and certainly do not do this. This is a bad idea. I don't usually do that, even if it's just kerosene, but I'm going to go ahead and eliminate that, eliminate those. Separate bags, we'll just leave them open sitting outside, and then if it starts a fire, it's not going to burn my house down.